Hello and welcome back to Ford Farm. So we've got another combine demo today. Dealership have just been through it with us. We have this old axle flow. Now I said we didn't want a rotary. I talked us into having a look at this one because it's such a clean combine for its age. This one is 12 years old. Or thereabouts, but done very little work. It's the right size for what we want. So we've got a bit of early drilled wheat which is ready. The oats aren't quite there yet, neither's the other bit of barley or the oilseed rape. So we're going to hit this field of wheat and get that done. This combine was demo was all agreed before the tract went wrong, or tractors went wrong I should say. This is exactly the right size, it's not too wide. It's the right size header for us. A little bit bigger than what we've got, but not ridiculously large, which has been a problem to find. We've got the John Deere on the trailer up here. So we're right next to the farmyard, it's not too bad. Get our background. Let's get the head hooked on there. We have driven one of these in the past, so I do know a bit about them. Hence why the dealer hasn't come out with it. Right, let's just get that back away from that trailer. It's all hooked up. See how we get on. It's got a bigger grain tank on this combine which should be useful for us. We're chopping this field as well. Dusty old field. So we really want to test the combines in barley, but there's not a lot we can do if we haven't got any ready. Fitted the GPS on this one as well. In the 2008 exclusive model, it's got quite a high spec on it. It's new as the John Deere we looked at. It's in just as good condition. Same width header, a bigger capacity combine. Good field to test on with how uneven this one is. Looks to be a damn good crop of wheat as well. As we're chopping, it should make full use of the power. So sharp if it is going to be suitable here. Tank is filling up nicely there. Get John Deere on the field when we get back up the top here. To be fair, it doesn't matter too much to us if the straw is smashed up a bit, because we use straw blower for bedding. Don't roll it out manually. Leave that track clear through there if we need it. Try not to use that gateway too much if we can. Track has been a bit soft down between those barns before. The instance involving the barn walls. And I have suggested we try to Deutz combine out what they've got coming in, but it's far too small for us. It's only 15-foot cut. 15-foot is no good for us. Just get down there a bit. Get John Deere in there. It's a nice job around there. Chopping it well. Just get that backed up a bit. Haven't got very high tractors and trailers, so the lower spout isn't going to make too much difference to us. There. And away we go again, so I'll carry on and get a bit more of these headlands done and see you in a few moments. Right. Three rounds of the headlands are off. We've now got one full trailer. I've walked back and got the other trailer onto the field. So far, I'm quite impressed with this combine. Doing everything we need it to. They did run the dividers out, they forgot to give them to me at the dealership. So they brought them up here. That's why they're now on the machine. We'll get the drone up anyway and see what's going on then. Once we see what the cameras are up to on here. Let's see, we've got some extra cameras fitted on here, so I'm just showing off. There's one on the hitch and one on the unloading auger. Dusty old field. The moisture's nice and low on the wheat at the moment. This should all go for milling on here. Hopefully. Leaving a nice even spread of straw on here. Said I wouldn't have a rotary, but it's doing a good job. How long we've got this one for to look at? Others they've talked about bringing us to have a look as well. One of them was fairly new. The other one's a little bit older than this. just top this trailer up this time. Do on that one, I think. Got this block off this side now. Everything else should go in the other trailer. A bit of luck. Too much left in this bit. Not a lot left over that side either. Don't really grow too much wheat, to be honest. Usually more barley than wheat. Just depends on what our cropping is like. Another field to go out of wheat yet. That was a bit later drilled. The wheat field was drilled behind sugar beet. This one was behind oilseed rape. Thought I caught a molehill that side, or bulldozed. Pushed over, but I'll just try and get it from this direction. Shall we scrape it all up? Pain when that happens. It's just caught the fingers a little bit down there. Around and a bit here. Well, it'll be around, actually. Look at that. I don't want to finish this now. Out nicely. Right. It's our first bit of wheat done for the year. Handy thing with this camera set up on here. If we just cycle through to the unloading auger one. You can see if it's right above the trailer. Handy. Right. Nice clean stubble on here. Just leaves me two trailers empty, but that is where we'll be leaving this video. So for now, I'll say thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video, and I will see you again next time. Goodbye for now.